it's HoppingHammy, and welcome back to another video on my channel. And if you're a first-time viewer, I'd like to say welcome to you also, and I hope that you enjoy watching this video. So in today's video, I am very happy because I wanted to show you guys the project that I've talked a bit about, and I told you guys I've been working on this for a little while. It did take longer than I thought it was going to take, but it was so worth it, and I'm just so excited I can like hardly contain myself. So this is a huge answer to prayer for me because I've been really needing more space to film my videos in, and just an area that's has more privacy and that I'm able to set up my lighting and like make a huge mess if I need to and not feel like I have to pick it up right away because, you know, like my family is walking through and I don't want them to trip on my cords or anything. So we've done some changing around in the house, and it's great because this not only will be benefiting me to have my own space, but other people in my family are also getting their own space now, and it just worked out really great for everybody to do this kind of like change around. So I'm so thankful, and I realize that probably most YouTubers on YouTube don't necessarily have like a designated filming area, and I realize that this is incredibly special. So I'd like to say a huge thank you to my family for allowing me to use this room and for helping me to set it up, and I'm so happy about it. So I'm gonna go ahead and get into the tour now, and I hope you guys enjoy watching it. On my hamster channel, I'm going to start off by showing you guys the left side, which is where all of the Habitrail OVO cages are, and I was so happy to set these back up again because I've missed them a lot. Some of you who have been with my channel for a while might remember that I had these set up in my bedroom at one point, and I had to take them down because I didn't have room for them, but I am able to set all of them up again. I think I used up all of the tubes. There might be like one that I didn't use, but I had a design from past that I had taken a photo of, and I saved it on my phone, so I was able to refer to that for some of the design, and then the rest of it I kind of just made up as I went along, and it didn't take as long as I thought. It took me like one day to put this together. I thought it was going to take me a lot longer than that, but the colors are just so pretty. So one very important thing I wanted to mention about these Habitrail OVOs is to please not use them as a main cage for your hamster. I know they look super awesome, and seeing them all set up with the tubes and everything is like all fancy, and I know I'm kind of promoting them in a way, but please don't use them as a main cage for your hamster. You can, however, use them as an add-on, like a smaller compartment. If you have one large cage, you can add some tubes and your hamster will definitely enjoy using these pods, but you want to make sure that you have a large area for them to be able to run, to dig, to have a proper sized wheel. I just wanted to mention that because I'd feel really bad if somebody went out and bought them because they thought they looked cool in my video. One positive that I have to say about these that I really, really like is the locking mechanism on the connectors. They have these connectors here, and you can see there's the locking device here, and you just twist them and then it locks really tightly, and they are very secure. Like, I've never had an issue with these coming undone so long as you attach them properly, but I don't plan on using this to put Cashie in as a play cage or anything like that. Number one, I don't want to have to clean all these tubes, and number two, I don't really feel like she would enjoy it. Like, I think she likes her cage that she's in, and I don't know what she would think of the tubes. So I don't plan on using this. I'm just gonna leave it set up as a background. I do really love how the OVOs look. Like I said, those are the OVOs, and they are on these two file cabinets, and these are just office file cabinets, but I was able to get them for a really good deal, and you might be able to find some like it at thrift stores, but they are amazing for storage. And then I have these circle rugs, which kind of match the circle OVO theme. Okay, so starting in the top right, this one I am using for all of my wooden and hay and like natural type of items. And these are mostly all Syrian items except for a few things like this little house and this little barrel. But it's nice to have them all together because that way when I do themed cages, I'm able to just open up the drawer and see everything that I have. This one is a continuation of some wood things, but these are like really, really big wood things that weren't really able to fit in the other drawer. There's also some cork. So yeah, these drawers are very deep and they are great for storage. I'm gonna move over here. This bottom drawer, okay, so this one has a ton of critter trail tubes, which most of these I got for a really good deal, or I got them for free many years ago. I didn't spend all that much money on these tubes, but I did collect them like crazy. So one day in future, if I have a dwarf again, I might use some of these tubes to connect my tanks. I'm not sure, but I'm just saving them for now and hoping that I can use them. So then in this top drawer, this is like the poly resin type of items. You guys will remember this. Cashy's had in her cage before, and there's some really cute things. Great for cage tours. So yeah, I really like these drawers just to be able to quickly take a look at what I have. And that is it for that. So I will move on now. On this side, there is a window. It's very bright, so let me adjust my light real quick. Okay, I switched the camera to auto, so it's going to look really dark now, but hopefully it will adjust okay. So up on the top here, I have some pink flowers, one on each side, just to bring out all of the colors. And these curtains have sparkle dots on them. They're really pretty. I originally got them from walmart.com, but I think you can find them on Amazon. If you search for groovy sequin curtain panel, that's what they're called. This is the window, and then down here, this is one of my favorite little areas that I think I will be filming in. This is a corner of pillows, and then I have this cute pink cat that I won at a round one arcade. So that is down there on the floor, and then this door over here, I have a cute hamster photo that is hanging up. This was given to me by my friend on the Hamster Hideout forum, and it's so, so cute. Reminds me of Strudel. So on the background behind the OVOs, you probably noticed this, I don't even know what you call it. It's like a holographic ribbon curtain, and I got this at Five Below, and it just adds enough color back there without looking too busy. Depending how the light hits it, it adds some like holographic color. I have these flowers. They're like netting. They're made of netting, and I'm trying to remember now where I got them. I don't even know. It might have been Hobby Lobby, but those are back there. I also hung some very colorful Christmas lights. So I guess I will show you guys these drawers. These I got so long ago. They are similar to some that are at IKEA, but I didn't get them from IKEA. So inside, oh, that one is empty. I don't even know what is in these drawers. I have some hamster supplies. So these are like little hamster chews and stuff. These are some clay mushrooms that I made a long time ago for a photo shoot. I don't put them in the cage for chewing on. I just use them for like photos and stuff. And then down here, I believe I have some more. Yes, these are like all of the food ones. And I can't wait to use more of these in my cage tours this year. And then let's see what is up here. I get some more hamster chews and this like nesting confetti colorful bedding stuff. This is a drawer of random things. And yeah, I'm not really sure what to say, but yeah, that's fun. And then this last one has some more like, this is the seasonal drawer, I think. Is it? I don't know. I can't remember. Yeah, I have like some Easter and some Halloween chews and stuff. So then over on this side, I have another drawer set, and this is not hamster supplies, but I do have like some ears up in these drawers that I keep, and I won't show you guys everything, but There's like ears in these drawers. I have some jewelry and like some floral crowns and some other props and stuff. Also nail polish, so that's fun. And then down here in the corner, this is my punchy flower pot that I used to have in my room, and I missed it so much because they're like the smiling flower family and they make me smile every time I see them. So I was very happy to be able to bring that back out again and put it down here. So then if we turn to the left, this is being used as a storage area for more hamster supplies, and I just have a wooden vanity that used to be my vanity in my bedroom, and then I also have another file cabinet and some bins. So I'm going to start off over here with these bins. These are some that I found at Target a few years ago, and they do still have this style at Target, but they have blue and kind of like a raspberry pink color this year. So I also have these paper lantern lights that some of you might remember from my old room tours, and I definitely saved these because I liked them so much. So that is just going around the bins. Now on the top I have some photos of my past hamsters, and this one on the left is cookies and cream, the one in the middle is whipped cream, and then the one on the far right is cream puff. There's an adorable hot pink octopus that is just sitting on the middle section. And then over on this side, I have more hamster photos. The one on the left is Teddy Graham. The one in the middle is Bavarian Cream. And then there is Cream Brulee, a little robo over here. She looks similar to Ginger Snap, but she was actually my first robo I ever had. So yeah. You can't really tell what's in these bins because I put paper over them just to make it look a little bit more simple, but I have some hamster wheels and hamster like flying saucers in this top one. This one has bedding. I think this one has bedding too, and this one's just like some miscellaneous little plastic accessories and stuff, I think. I kind of put that in there a little while ago, but yeah, that is good for storage. Inside of these drawers, I have camera equipment, which I will show on my second channel, but I did want to show you guys these adorable little magnetic animals that I have on the handles. There is a pig, there is a cow, and then this one is a donkey, and they just hang on there with their little feet, and then there's the same one on the other side. I managed to find like three of these I found at a thrift store, and then I went in another store that same day, I think it was Hobby Lobby, and I like managed to find a little buddy for each of them, so that was really cute, and I just thought they looked fun up there. So before I go any farther, I did want to mention the white wall thing that you see in the background. It's actually not a wall, of course, but it is like a white plastic bag, and they use these to like prevent dust when you're getting your house remodeled and stuff. And we ended up putting this up to work as a wall to give me some privacy in my area, and also to like hide my mess when I make a mess, because I make messes quite often. So those are working really well. There's just like a tension rod that is holding it up. There's three rods across here. So it worked out really, really well, but it was like not as much work as putting up walls. So that is what that is, just in case you were wondering. So anyways, moving on, this is my 40-gallon breeder tank that I got a while back, and I am still keeping it for like a spare tank. In front of the tank I have this sign that just says beware hamster on patrol, and then there is a hamster up there. So this sign was given to me by my friend Joy Georgina, and she lives in Scotland, so I don't know if they sell this like in the US, I'm not sure, they probably do, but I also have this little cute flower up here that another friend made for me. This is my stress relief little squishy hamster that looks like Cashie, and she is guarding the tank. So then above that, this is my unicorn pinata that I had in my unicorn room last year, and I took it out until summer, and then I'm going to put it back in there, so I just thought it would be fun to put it up there. And then on each side I have some speakers that my brother was so kind to give to me, and these are Bluetooth speakers so that I'm able to come out here with my phone and I can play music. Sometimes I like to listen to music while I do photography, or I can listen to nature sounds or whatever. They're really, really nice speakers. So then there is this file cabinet, which was also something that I was able to get for a really good deal. Again, good for storage. And you might notice these photos I put on. These are magnet frames. I have a photo of my hamster, my past hamster Strudel. And then over on this side, I have a photo of my past hamster Yodel. And I will go ahead and show you guys what is in these drawers. So in the top drawer, these are pretty stuffed, by the way. So this is mostly plastic stuff that I don't tend to use quite as much, and I kind of just piled it all in the top drawer. There's some igloos, I have a little school bus, this is something that I want to use for like a photo shoot, and I have a little adorable critter castle. Some of these are like dwarf sized toys as well. So I haven't had a chance to use them with Cashy because she wouldn't be able to fit. This, I do want to do a space themed hamster cage hopefully sometime this year, so I will be able to use that. That was a gift from my friend Sparkle Girl. And then the second drawer, this is where it starts my ceramics. Well, okay, other than this castle which couldn't fit in the top, but I do have some ceramic items. And these I just use for my various cage tours, so it's nice to have a place to store them. And then this third drawer, these are all of the seasonal ceramics, so like Christmas, Halloween, Easter, Valentine's Day, all of those. It's nice to keep them all together. And then down in this last drawer, this drawer needs to be kind of organized a little bit better, but I have some little mini things that I like to put in my cages, like little tiny things. An empty shoebox, some popsicle sticks, and this is Cashy's sandbox, which I don't have in her cage currently because she has Eco Earth, but I will be putting it back in. So some of the stuff I had to take out of her cage and I just like temporarily put it in here. I have this lamp, which I'm able to have three different lights that are on, and then I also have this wooden cabinet thing which I'm using to put some cutesy things in. So I apologize if the lighting is horrible over here. Let me see if I can get it to look a little better. On the top here there is this IKEA, okay, I call it the hamster nightlight. I know it's not actually hamster, but it kind of looks like it. And then I have these like candle, glass candle holder things. And then in here, this I'm using to display some of my little hamster things, and a lot of these were given to me by friends. I have some Pick Me Pop toys, and you guys, these still smell so good. Like, I smell like chocolate and mint and strawberry and all these smells every time I walk by here. So there's the hamster in the back that's in one of those battery operated wheels. And then this shelf has some little hamster figurines, and these were given to me by a friend many years ago, but I think they do sell them on eBay, and if I'm able to remember the name, I will put it on the screen for you guys. Down here are some more Pick Me Pops, and there are three different hamsters. I don't remember their names without looking at the paper, but this one has waffle cone ears. And there's that one. This one is a little reindeer. And then there's this one as well. So those are so fun to collect. Me and my friend Taxonomous, we like got a whole bunch of those one time and we just like collected them. So there's also these three teacups back here. And then down here, I have some button keychains that were given to me by Chocolate Colors 20. Oh, wait, sorry. Victoria Rachel. She used to be Chocolate Colors 26, but yeah, she made those and she sent them to me, which was really, really sweet. So then down in this cabinet below, this is where I keep my Hello Kitty collection, and I do have a few more things that were not able to fit in here, like larger Hello Kitty plushes, but I'll just give you guys a quick overview, and maybe one day I will do a Hello Kitty like collection video on my second channel. Okay, so the opposite side of my studio area is more so for my other types of videos that I make, but I do have some hamster stuff that I will show you guys very briefly, and if you're interested in seeing a detailed tour on the rest of my supplies and such, you can go to my second channel. I will put a link in the description and also one of those clickable cards on the screen. So I forgot to mention, you might be wondering where the door is to get out of here, and there's actually a zipper, if you guys can see, over here there's this black zipper that runs down on both sides, and that I can just unzip, and this whole door you can roll up, and I'm able to go in and out with like lights and stuff like that if I need to, but generally I keep it closed for privacy. So this over here, this is my section of storage bins. I just got these recently at Target, and I love the colors because like I'm able to stagger the bins so that it's like pink, blue, and it looks really fun. So I'm not going to show in detail everything in the bins, but I mostly have some props and like extra curtains and backdrops and that. There's some bedding in there, which that was kind of an overflow bin, but anyways, I'll talk more about that in my other video. Over here has some other props for some videos I want to do, and also there's a mirror. Hi! This area is my secondary storage, and I do have one of those zippable portable wardrobe things that I store my ballet costumes in over here. And above that, there is a photo that I have. Well, it's like an art that one of my friends in past made me of my hamster cream puff. I wanted to put that up there. So then over here, there is a butterfly and a jellyfish that's just hanging because I thought it looked fun. And you might remember this lamp and these photos from my previous room tours. Again, I have Yodel on the right and Strudel on the left with these cute little flower candles. So this is another thing that I am very excited about having, is this space for my DIY cage to be. And previously I had it kind of tucked away in another room, and I had to like move it out every time I wanted to do a cage tour, which was a huge pain. So now I have a place that I'm able to just leave it set up, and I will be doing more cage tours this year. I'm hoping to do a Valentine's Day one, and it's not going to be probably super fancy like last year's cage tours, but that's okay, I'll still enjoy it anyway. So I just have this flower pot down there for now, which obviously I will have to take out when I fill it with bedding, but yeah. So then on the far left, there is another storage cabinet, and this one I am using for all of my hamster bedding. There's some more on the top that wasn't able to fit, and this bin above is for stuff for my second channel as well. But I wanted to show you guys on the front, there is this cute hamster calendar, and I like to flip it to see all of the different hamster photos every month, so that's something I look forward to doing. This was given to me by my friend Taxonomist as well, and I just love it so much. So I'm gonna try to move this calendar so that I can show you guys inside of the cabinet. So this cabinet was bought at Goodwill, and it was in great condition, and it has some adjustable shelves as well. So it is really, really handy to store bedding. And the problem that I have is when I take bedding out of the bag, like out of these original packaging, I have to put it in big garbage bags because I can't really fit it back in. When I use bedding for cage tours, I don't throw it out after one tour. I will reuse it and make use of it because I don't want to be wasteful. So this is all of the bedding that I'm hoping to kind of use up this year, and you can't even see all of it. There's a lot of it behind, but a lot of this was given to me by Carefresh for doing their videos, and I appreciate it so much because I didn't have to go out and buy bedding. So this is a goal that I'm hoping to use up some of this bedding. So then the last of my hamster storage is in these IKEA bins, and I'm trying to remember the name of them, but I'll look it up and I will put it on screen. So I just got two more recently, and I haven't put anything in them yet, but I will. On the top there is this unicorn hat, which I thought looked really, really cute up there. And then down in these bins, it's kind of hard to tell, but I have some hamster books that are in this one. This one has some miscellaneous dwarf-sized toys. This one has some more dwarf-sized toys. Mostly these are all like plastic stuff that I don't use that much. And then this one has some ceramic dwarf-sized toys. So when I get a dwarf in future, I will be using those a lot more often. But with Cashie, it's not really something I'm able to use for her. So I just keep them in these handy-dandy bins. The last area is over here, and this is what I'm using for my filming area for other types of videos that I film for my second channel, such as ballet stuff. I do some fantasy videos, some random stuff. I have a lot planned for this year, but this is a great wall that I'm able to put up a backdrop or just leave it plain. And then I have my lights and my ballet bar that I made. And I'm not gonna like go into a huge amount of detail because I'll show that on my other channel, but that is just that. And I think that is pretty much it for the hamster stuff that I wanted to show you guys. I hope you enjoyed this tour. And again, I am just so incredibly happy and grateful to have this area to use. I think it's gonna work out really great, and it's something that is just like so amazing, so I'm very, very thankful. But thank you guys so much for watching, and if you have any other questions about this room, feel free to ask, but I will see you in my next video. Bye.